This presentation introduces compound resources, assemblers, and disassemblers. Many processes involve vehicles or containers that contain other resources which travel through the network. When vehicles or containers enter queues, then the resources they contain must also wait with them and be released when the vehicle or container is drawn by the following combi. Stroboscope allows us to model vehicles or containers by using compound resources. In this example, we shall introduce a compound resource called a loaded hauler, which will contain both a hauler and the soil that is inside the hauler itself. The compound resource loaded hauler will act as a container that contains both the hauler and the soil and allows them to travel together through the network. As an example, consider a situation where the amount of soil loaded into a hauler is uncertain. In other words, it was drawn through a probabilistic process. In that case, when the hauler enters the queue wait to dump, the soil that it carries must also enter with it. And when the hauler is drawn by link HL3 into an instance of activity dump, then the soil that the hauler carries with it must also be drawn by the instance of dump. In this model, this is accomplished by the fact that the queue wait to dump does not contain the characterized type resource hauler, but contains the compound type loaded hauler. As a result, when an instance of activity dump starts, it removes one loaded hauler and keeps it for the duration of the instance of dump. How this network works can best be described by following the links and nodes after the load activity. There are two links coming out of the load activity, HL2, which carries the hauler, and SL2, which carries the soil. Both of these links go into an assembler shown as a circle with a letter A inside it, which is called Make L Hauler. The purpose of the assembler is to take the incoming resources, in this case a hauler and the soil, and to combine them together into a container called L Hauler. The L hauler then flows out through the link LH1 and enters into a new instance of activity haul. When an instance of activity haul terminates, it releases the compound resource loaded hauler into the queue wait to dump, which contains resources of the compound type loaded hauler. When an instance of activity dump starts, it removes one resource of type loaded hauler from the queue wait to dump and keeps it for the duration of the instance of dump. After that instance terminates, the loaded hauler is released through link LH4 and it is transferred to the succeeding node, Break L Hauler. That node is a disassembler. The purpose of a disassembler is to disassemble the incoming compound resource into the component resources that originally went into making the compound resource. In this case, the loaded hauler will be broken down into a hauler and the soil. The hauler will then flow through link HL5 and go into a new instance of activity return, and the soil will flow through link SL4 and go to soil moved. The important thing to appreciate in this model is this. If the amount of soil drawn by an instance of activity load is random, then we do not really know how much soil that was, but the model does. And when that amount of soil is released through SL2, it is packaged together with a hauler into this compound resource called a loaded hauler. When the loaded hauler is disassembled in the disassembler Break L Hauler, then that exact amount of soil is released through link SL4 and it's delivered to the queue soil moved. If we wanted to know how much soil was actually loaded into an instance of load and how much of it was delivered into soil moved, we would have to have on-release statements for link SL2 or for link SL4 to collect statistics into a collector about the amount of soil that was currently in the corresponding link. The statements required for this model are remarkably simple. The compound type L-hauler, which stands for a loaded hauler, is defined by just one statement, comp type L-hauler. Notice that a comp type does not have any properties. The next three statements, draw until, draw amount, and draw duration, regulate the drawing of soil from the queue soil to move through link SL1. What is important about these statements is that the statement draw amount allows SL1 to draw a probabilistic amount of soil from the preceding queue. In this case, the amount of soil drawn equals shovel size times a uniformly distributed random number between 85% and 105%. The draw until statement allows link SL1 to draw soil until the amount of soil drawn exceeds 90% of the capacity or the size of the hauler in load. The draw until and the draw amount for link SL1 work together to allow an instance of load to draw a random amount of soil from link soil to move. This exact amount of soil will then flow through link SL2 and will be assembled together with the hauler into a compound resource L-hauler. When the compound resource L-hauler reaches the disassembler, the hauler will then be given to an instance of activity return and the soil will flow through link SL4 into the queue soil move. Compound resources are used when we want to model the movement of resources that are carried by containers that themselves can be carried by containers. For example, a ship can contain containers and a container can contain other equipment. As a result, the equipment can be characterized resources, the container can be a compound type, and the ship itself can also be a compound type that contains a compound type that contains characterized resources and possibly other resources.